Hello, everyone. Welcome to Locking It In with Deb and Pear, our real estate report for July 12, 2021. And for those who haven't met us, I'm Deb.
I'm Pear.
We are a realtor and a loan officer, and together we'll bring you this market report and lots of information about real estate. Hopefully every week, it might sometimes be every 2 weeks, because we're all busy selling real estate, doing mortgages, and our other lives. Today, I really want to talk about how affordable homes are right now. So many potential home buyers, particularly first-time home buyers, they really don't think that they can afford a home, and they're really wrong. According to a survey by Realtor.com, recently, the Realtor.com conducted a survey of potential home buyers. Most of them indicated they couldn't afford their first home and it was cheaper for them to rent. And according to the survey, 47% of these buyers were surprised by how affordable homes actually are today. To make a point, owning a home is more affordable than renting because, first of all, the rates are at record lows. Mortgage payments are about 23% lower than 20 years ago. 40% of survey responders had a bigger budget than they realized. According to George Ratiu, the senior economist at Realtor.com, for the first time homebuyers, especially with the drop in the 30-year mortgage rate, has provided unexpected leverage. Lower rates allow many homebuyers to stretch and buy more expensive homes while keeping their monthly budget the same. Now, Perrin, I don't know if you want to comment on this, but I kind of made it an example. This is very simple. Without taxes or homeowners insurance or anything, I just took a simple amortization schedule for a 30-year mortgage for $400,000 versus a 30-year mortgage at $300,000. If you qualify today for $400,000 mortgage, that means with 3% interest, you would have a payment before taxes and insurance of under $1,700 a month. And that's what you will pay essentially for the life of your mortgage. It will go up a little bit for taxes and that's it. And the total out that you would pay for that mortgage over the life of the mortgage, if you paid it off after 30 years, would be $607,000. When the interest rates go up, they'll hit 4%, then 5%. Let's just look at the difference. At 5%, to buy that same house, your payment is now over $2,000. And that might be just enough so that you don't qualify for $400,000 anymore. And you'll have to buy a $380,000 house instead. Interest rates are going to go up. Home prices are not likely to go down.
Yeah, interest rates are projected to, the Federal Reserve Board's going to meet in 2023. And they said that they would raise rates twice that year. I don't expect rates to go up very much. Interest rates will go up probably 0.5% or 0.75% from where they are now.
Right. And over time, as the years go on.
The
rates will eventually go up potentially higher. And if you have a $300,000 mortgage financed at 4%. Let's say the rate goes up to 4%. Now you're paying $1,432 a month, which is a couple hundred dollars more than what it cost at 3% for your $400,000 mortgage. It could mean the difference between finding a house or not finding a house if the interest rates go up. And the same is true if you're planning to upscale, if you want to buy a nicer house, you want to do that now because your equity will get, it will become much less valuable when the interest rate's higher because you won't be able to buy as expensive of a house as you can now, potentially. This is a very important thing to know. In the inventory, it's going to gradually get bigger. Just slowly but surely, you're going to see things opening up already. And I would say now is the time, if you're thinking about buying or selling, to call a realtor and your loan officer as soon as possible, at least get an idea. What can you afford right now? What are your realistic options? One thing's for sure, you're going to sell your house.
Yeah, it's a seller's market. even more and more every month.
Right. The earlier that you start looking at the inventory, the sooner you will find a home and the better price you will get. Something that I hear people say too often. Have you heard this, Perrin? People talk about how they want to live debt-free and have no mortgage.
Yes.
I always say it's not a good idea in most cases. What do you think?
Well, if you have a hard time making the payment, it's a good idea. Otherwise, it's good to have the write-off.
If you have a hard time making the payment, you're not going to be able to pay it off.
Well,
depends. We're talking about people want to pay their mortgage off. They want to pay extra money to pay off their mortgage. So instead of paying off, using that money for other things, they pay it all off on their mortgage right up front. So you have a bunch of cash. You have cash invested or cash in the bank. You pay off your home and now you have no cash. And your home is not a cash asset. You can't skim cash off your house. If you want to access your home equity, you have two choices. You can sell your home or you can borrow it at interest. And in the meantime, that cash that you used to pay down your mortgage, you could have used a better idea, pay down your high interest credit cards or other loans.
Well, that's true. That should be the first option. Pay down your higher interest rate loans and then work on your home.
Don't do it too quickly. If you have a mortgage, you can deduct 100% of the interest on the mortgage, which is virtually 100% of your payment in the first 10 or more years. You can deduct 100% of that interest off on your taxes. It's $750 or $1 million if your mortgage started before 2018. And that's a lot of money that you don't have to pay taxes on. But if you pay your mortgage off, you don't get that tax write-off and you also don't get the other cash investments, that cash growth from stocks and bonds or even buying another home, which will give you a cash flow. And when you sell that home, you will pay 100% capital gains on the net price if you own it. Capital gains tax will be a big deal. But here's the biggest thing right here. At the end of the day, you're not going to save interest on your mortgage by paying it down. It's not going to be of value because the amount of money that you could make with other financial vehicles, the amount of growth that you can get is excessive. And when you pay off your mortgage, not only can you not write it off when you have to pay capital gains, when you have a hardship, what you need is cash. If you have a hardship, you're not going to be able to get a mortgage to get cash out of your home. The only way you would be able to do it is to sell it. When you're in a hardship, that great, wonderful asset you have can't help you if you don't have a mortgage. Things such as if you have cash in the bank, if you have that cash invested in other assets,
it's easy access.
Then you can get to it when you need it. If you have an emergency medical bill or emergency travel expenses, it's not going to come from your house unless you pay interest on it and you're capable of borrowing against it at the time. But in your biggest hour of financial need, your home equity will not be there for you.
Yeah, it takes time to refinance your house.
And you have good credit.
Whereas if you have mutual funds or some kind of other money in the bank or something, then you have access almost immediately to that money.
But the bigger issue here is when you find yourself in that financial need and you want to get cash out, you're going to have difficulty finding a loan. Even though it's your home and you own all this equity, the lenders are not going to lend money to you if you don't qualify for the loan. And if you just lost a job and you're sick and you can't work, you're going to have a hard time.
Yeah, I actually had someone call me last week in that situation where he lost his job. He actually still has his job, but he can't work. He's still employed, but he can't work because he hurt his leg and he can't walk. He's got money in the bank, thank heaven. He wanted to refinance so he wouldn't have to access that money, but he couldn't because he doesn't have an income right now.
He can't even make his payment lower.
He owns his mortgage free and clear, but he has two very high car payments, like $600, $700 each.
The total is a mortgage.
It is. And he's 61 and he also wants to do a reverse mortgage, but you have to be 62 to do that. So he has to wait a year, just over a year to do that.
And in the meantime, he's got all this equity he can't use.
Exactly. And his house is worth $450,000 or more. And he owns it free and clear. Yeah. And he has no access to his equity.
Yeah. So imagine that you're all ready to retire. You got $400,000 and you can't use it. This is not where you want to be. You want to have that cash. You don't want to use your retirement either to pay off your mortgage. That's not smart. It's good to have a retirement and it's good to have liquid assets always. Just for a reminder, last week I mentioned that here in the state of Washington, the average homeowner equity increased $66,000 in the last year.
Oh, yeah.
$66,000.
That's average. Some people some people's equity went over $100,000 over the last year.
It depends on the value of your home.
Well, actually,
and this is mostly based on value over the mortgage. I don't think it's including the mortgage, or maybe it's including everything.
It's over the mortgage. And I've got one borrower that went $170,000 over his equity from last year. I've got others that only went $35,000 over, but that $35,000 is a lot of money too, frankly. And the average is $66,000. Yeah. Everybody
I think
really cashed in that owns a house.
Went up at least $66,000.
It did. It went like 70, 75.
And we didn't do anything. We just made our payments every month. And fortunately, the payments don't go up because they're not rent.
Yes.
It's a fixed mortgage payment every month.
So actually, it gets more affordable every year.
Yes.
Because your income goes up.
Yeah. And you're writing more off on your taxes as well. You're getting a huge discount on your taxes, thousands of dollars a year.
This year was really great for homeowners. It really was. And for sellers. It was a really great year. And it's good for buyers too, because interest rates are so low.
Yeah. If you are a hesitant home buyer or a hesitant seller, give us a call. You owe it to yourself at least to get an understanding of where you sit and what you can do at the moment. You don't want to let this opportunity go to waste. I know that during the 2009 situation, I was really wishing I had a ton of money to
buy
a
real
bunch
estate.
Of houses, because I thought, wow, the market on real estate's crashing. Now this is when I want to buy them up. But we're not dealing with this right now. What we are dealing with now, it's not a bubble. This is reflecting real demand on the market. It's a stable, healthy economy in that regard. And it's only going to become more normal as we move out of this pandemic. Interest rates will go up. Competition for homes will go up. It's really the time to start reviewing this is now. If you have questions, any of you, please let us know in the comments or send us a chat or an email. I think all are available. And we will respond or answer your question maybe on our next report.
Thank you.
Thank you. And this has been Locking It In with Devin Pear for Monday, July
12th,
2021. Have a great week.
Thank you. Enjoy that equity.